found on the track by the Punch Brothers. Oof, who's that phoning me back? Yeah, stare at. Hi, who's that? What's your name? What's your point caller?
Well, yeah, it's Liam, 3478
after Twitter.
Stay there
and I'll phone you back, mate.
Cool, pal.
Right, we at the game, caller. We at the game. Right, and we're going to dismantle the Rembrandt Classic. They're also crackpots in Amsterdam. We're going to be phoning the night crackpot, whoever's there.
Hello, Tommy, can you hear me?
Aye, mate, what's happening?
Aye, you phoned me there a minute ago. I was trying to say hello and you couldn't hear me, so... Aye, how are you?
No, but hide, mate. Were you at the game then, caller? Were you at the game?
No, I was a fuck. I mean, Cumbernauld is a fuck. Try for Amsterdam, innit?
Who's it called? Cumbernauld? No, next stop, no, Amsterdam?
To be honest with you, there's more whores in Cumbernauld, but that's another story.
Is there? Hey, taxi to Cumbernauld, anybody want a lift?
Oof, that's what I'm going to say
is oof. So what's happened? Did you watch the game then,
Liam? I did, Tommy. I watched it late. I watched it on the live pause in the Sky because my wee lassie was up late. And I watched it in the Sky Plus. What was your take on it? Can you your take on it first?
Well, it's under investment in the team and just unlucky with injuries and suspension. I think if we had Brown, Mulgrew, I think if Sam and Acid Commons were a wee bit fitter, and if we had, I don't know, they're not that great team, Ajax, so I just feel we could have done better, but with certain circumstances, everything combined, you know, if we had Finn Borgeson, it would have made a difference. I don't think Pookie's any good, I don't think Boa Strictor's any good, but you've got to go what you've got, and they've only going to change anything, so fuck it, well.
You kind of nailed it there right away when you said about the lack of investment in the squad in the summer, and I think that's imperative as to the problem tonight, because there was nothing at all up top. I can't remember. I'm an age where I've seen great players like Eric Larson and John Holland and all these guys, and I can't remember a Celtic team that's never had any kind of goal threat, and that's what they were cutting me right. There was no goal threat at all, Tommy, you know what I mean?
I know, mate, I know.
That's no Celtic, is it?
Do you reckon Stokes was worth his new contract?
At SPL level, yes, but at European level, no, he's dead,
isn't he? He's only had this season, and, I mean, if you look at it, what chances have they had? He's not really had much service. I mean, if you look at the midfield is bereft. See what you're saying there? The midfield is bereft of any creativity and they're relying on wingers. If you're not getting in behind them, if Lustig isn't hitting the byline or Matthews or Izaguirre, then there's nothing getting played in. But even when they play it in, who have they got there to play it into? Because the predatory striker that was Hooper isn't there. We've not replaced him with anybody predatory. So what do they go for? They go with the inventiveness of Commons and Samaras. And if they're not at the game, then what else is there? Because there's nobody else inventive apart from A2. And unless you're a winger, I mean, what are you putting a ball in the box when you've not got a striker there to clear it up? So that's what we're missing. A striker, like you say, somebody like Hooper. If it was going to be Finn Borgeson, then it would be him. Because I think Stokes is a backup striker and an SPL striker, like you say, and maybe he's not suited to the Champions League, but can you damn it?
I think there's a few players tonight that are showing up to win a Champions League level, and I think that you're looking at Stokes, in my opinion. Also, you're looking at Charlie Mulgrew, who I like Charlie Bill because he's a big Tim, and same with Stokes, is a big Celtic man, total Tims, and the merrier then you get team, in my opinion, the better, but if they're not good enough, they're not good enough. I thought about the park, I thought Birram Kyle looked as if he was maybe going to start coming back to being the player he was, actually. I know he could have a lot of fouls, but in spells, he looked as if he might be kind of coming back into a bit of life. But the biggest problem that I've got is, Tommy, and I was at Firhill was last Sunday, wasn't it? I was at Thurrell last Sunday for the game. And the only reason I went to the game is because a wee pal of mine got his tickets via the huddle board for a boy, and God bless him, a boy for somewhere in Saltcoats. Mate hasn't got his tickets because I wanted to go through and make a donation to the food bank. I was going to do it anyway, but I thought I could double up. We gone to the game, have a wee few couple of pints and stuff. I know that's not your style, Tommy, but we'll have a few pints and that and make a wee day it. And make a donation to the Maryhill Food Bank, which I usually did. But apart from that, I've not been going to the games all lately. And but what's worried me is when I'm looking at Celtic, you know, the guys that are standing out to me are Van Dijk and Mikael Lustig. And I don't ever remember in all my life looking at a Celtic team and the standout players were defenders. Do you know what I mean? You know, do you understand where I'm coming from?
Yeah, I hear you, aye.
And I don't know. When I look at it, I've spoken to you before, and already I've told you I'm a suspicious bugger, and I've got a suspicious mind, and I think of things, and I always look at the dark side of everything, and I, you know, and it kind of goes back to the Gordon Strachan time when we kind of, I don't know, we kind of curtailed Scott Brown. I thought Scott Brown, we signed him, was going to go and be an absolutely fantastic player, Scott Brown, but I think Celtic have destroyed him for the player that we signed. Do you know what I'm, you know where I'm coming for there?
Do you know he's had his best seasons so far this season?
Aye, but that's a yeah, yeah. Like he's been at Celtic for how many is it? About 4 years, 3 or 4 years. But what I mean is the player that we signed when I watched him play with Hibernian, he was a marauding midfielder that fucking ran at teams, and he was dangerous. He was a goal threat and stuff. And he looked dangerous, he looked lively, and yet we've kind of turned him into this kind of, you know, kind of sitting midfielder. I just, Tommy, I just don't know. I feel as if he could have been an absolute outstanding player.
But players change, Liam. Like, if you look at Stan Petrov, everybody was saying he'll go down to England, he'll be scoring 10 goals a season. And what did Martin O'Neill do? He changed him into a sitting player. He realised that maybe he wasn't the player he was at Celtic and the youth that he had, so you had to sit. And when you see a young player coming through, 2021, they're full of life and exuberance, but they need to develop something more to their game, and he's developed a lot more to a game, and he's more tactical nouse about him. And I mean, apart from that rash thing that he did with Neymar and that cunt playing up to it, he's been having a brilliant season. And I know what you're saying, he's no the positive thrusting thing that would you call it, but you have to remember he's got chocolate ankles, and he's just recovered from, you know, having injections and playing through the pain barrier for like the whole of Hingway, and then you find he's got a degenerative hip injury, so it's always going to get worse. So I don't know, mate, I just think he's not the player, but because age and then through illness and thing, where he's had to adapt his game, and I think he's the best we've got at holding the team together, mate. You need somebody that's a gel and a cohesive between defence and attack, and he might not be a Paul Lambert, and he might not be a Neil Lennon, and he might not be a Wanyama or whatever as a midfielder, but he's definitely better than a lot of what we've got to know, no?
I wouldn't agree with that, mate, but I thought tonight, to be honest with you, that I thought Kyle looked as if he might be coming back to being the player we thought he was going to be. And I know that a lot of guys, I listen to all the Celtic podcasts. I've been unfortunate. I've had 12 days off my work, so I'm way behind with everything. I tried to download all your stuff today because you're my number. You're my feet. Well, I know blowing smoke up your arse, Tommy, but I like your stuff. Like for more than one reason.
Can we shove your head up your chaffs and stop blowing snakes smoke up my tape? You'll be getting a ban. I'll be giving you a fucking ban anywhere to smoke up my tailpipe.
No, I know. But you cover all the different kind of facets. You cover the fucking conspiratory and all that. Right, okay, so that's why I prefer your stuff. So I'm trying to download it a day and my phone's still not got too much shit on my phone, so how do I get shorties? But anyway, what was saying there was Kyle, I thought Kyle looks as if he's maybe coming back to being a player that we thought he was going to be. And do you know what? See, looking at that match today, I thought tonight. I thought that Celtic looked actually pretty decent, although there was nothing from middle to front. I thought from middle to back, they looked okay. And I think that big Effie Ambrose, who has had a
nightmare at times, isn't he?
Aye, but I think he's fucking, he's got total quality. Total
quality? You're off your fucking nut. Look at that bass, but that back pass would have let them in. Fucking quality, my heart was in my mouth for that cunt.
But that's why you've got your heart in your mouth, because he's got ability. He's got ability, and he can bring the ball out. And
he's a fucking bomb scaring me.
Tommy, I played football, and I played football at centre back, right? And I'm only 5'11", so I'm not a big centre back. And all I done was fucking baffled people, thumped them, and pumped the ball to the park, right? That's MD can do that, but see when you've got a guy that can play a bit of football for the back, I think that's different, and I think that's a bit of what we're all about.
You bring a bit of football out of the back, and then you get caught and you end up causing a goal, and then that's what's lost the game. Fuck's sake. I'd rather have a dirty big bastard fucking full half who not only kicks the ball into Rose Ed, but the guy who's fucking facing his front teeth are in Rose Ed as well.
Oh, I know what you're talking about, but fuck's sake, I'm pretty... think
you're
a bit cultured as Celtic supporters.
Fuck Tommy, your culture, Rosehead. Agriculture's your culture, right? If it comes down to a guy putting his fucking heed down the ball or you're fucking fit in his face, then agriculture is teeth right to fucking next century, mate. Who's with you? A bit of culture. Fuck all this fucking namby-pamsy fucking playing the ball out for the back. Get rid of it and pass it to somebody. I mean, well, saying that, I can understand what you're saying, right? If Ambrose is coming out, right, call me old-fashioned, right, I'd prefer a Lennon or a fucking Wanyama to bring the ball out, because at least if they lose the ball, right, you've got a couple of fucking knuckle-draggers at the back are willing to go agricultural with it. So if you want somebody to get it, so once they've got it, all they should be looking today, right, all Lennon's position, if you remember back to Lennon and... I used to do my nothing because nobody could see what he did, but it was simple, and I think that's what made their defence. I mean, you had Baldy and Mialbe, and if you look at them, the simplest of them, they went agricultural and they went through whoever it was, and then as soon as they got the ball, right, it was as if Lennon knew, I need to get near these two fucking clowns. And well, Lennon's part, he was always near the ball anyway, because that was just his fucking, as soon as the ball, he hemmed in, and you saw him without even sliding in or fucking going heavy in a tackle, he kind of shouldered that, he was in there, but he was always close to it. So as soon as something happened or somebody got the ball, he was there to take it and then feed it away and get it away. So he was good at dispossessing, and he would very rarely fucking lose it, and he was a feeder. And that's the way I like football. So when you get two back players at the back, I don't think they should be doing anything with the ball except looking for someone, and a teammate should be close by, a defensive mid, waiting to take it off his defenders, and then he can do the Baresi, because if he's doing the Baresi and fucking walking out with it, we're not getting caught short. And all the time, I hear what you're saying, and I know Ambrose has got talent and he can come out, but when your last line of defence goes for walks, unless you've got a fucking strong midfield stepping back, you're chancing me fucking death, no?
Well, to be honest with you, I agree with exactly everything you've said, but I also like a defender that can take a ball out.
If you've not got a midfielder to step into his place, and if Celtic are playing a high thing, then we're losing a player. And if you look at a lot of the goals that Celtic lose, right, a lot of them are when we're dispossessed in that area between the 18-yard box and the centre circle. So you look at that area, if you lose a ball in there, right, that is a key place where you shouldn't lose the ball, because the other teams are pressing on you, because they know if they get the ball, the defence is flat-footed. If you get a couple of quick strikers, they're up that end of the pitch, and if they've got two or three there, then you're outnumbered, particularly if the person who loses the ball is a fucking defender. So if your defender has gone into the semi-circle and he loses the ball heading that way, then what's behind him? He's got one other central defender, two wide players, and is there another midfielder in there? Well, the only time I would like, or I would be able to take that happening, would be Wanyama or Lennon sitting there. But we've not got Wanyama or Lennon there to fill in, so we're fucking exposed all over the place then, if that happens. No?
The thing is, Tommy, it also depends on the way you're playing in teams. I've played in football teams before,